Yes?
Yes, Miss Ferguson.
Governor, I would like to make an official complaint.
Which means what?
Some of the women are actually getting to the point of enjoying their stay here.
And it's splendid.
They're supposed to be prisoners. It's not a holiday camp.
That sounds like a very good idea. Rather unusual, of course, and I shall have to get the department's permission. But I don't see them objecting too strongly.
If conditions are too lax, it only encourages them to become recidivists.
My thoughts exactly. Well.
Mrs. Davidson, you've met her, I take it?
Several times.
Formed any opinions of her? Professionally, I mean.
Oh, she's a very capable woman.
Oh, come on, Mr. Wilson, I'm not asking officially. Just for your impressions.
Erica Davidson? The governor.
I don't want promotion if it means having to sacrifice Erica.
Don't worry, Meg. You won't have to do a thing.
You do understand, Wendy?
Yes, Mrs. Davidson.
And when Mr. Goodwin arrives, he's to be shown directly to my office.
Yes, Mrs. Davidson.
Goodbye, Mrs. Davidson. And thanks. I'll see you tonight.
You'd better. Mr. Goodwin, how nice to see you again.
I wish I could say the same, Mrs. Davidson.
Oh, that sounds ominous.
It seems we have quite a few problems to resolve. Item, one suicide. Item, one death. Item, two escapes. Need I go on?
I hope not.
And quite apart from that, the department is concerned about stories to do with the distilling of illicit alcohol, about smuggled drugs.
Quite an impressive list of charges.
I'm sure any further action that need be taken will be taken by the department.
Without my even answering any of the matters you've brought up?
At the end of that, one hopes that the air will be cleared.
One hopes so.
This hasn't been very pleasant for you, has it?
No.
I don't like the look of this.
I think we share the same opinion on the subject of drugs, Mr. Goodwin.
And precisely what do you think you're doing, Miss Bennett?
Davidson, this is Mr. Goodwin, the visiting justice. You may sit down.
I've been looking at your file here, girlie. I don't like what I see. You've been sentenced here for a filthy crime, and you go on with it in here.
You know, your Miss Bennett only makes my job more difficult. I've got to undo all her good work in making those women feel worthless and crushing whatever hope they have in bettering themselves. God help us if she's any more than governor for a day.
What's come over her? I mean, let's be frank. She was always pretty wet, but this pathetic imitation of an old lag isn't just irritating, it's so damn stupid.
Can I say something?
Yes, of course.
Well, her father...
Look, if she goes into court looking the way she is, then she's going to catch whatever they're throwing. I do have other clients, you know, people who are interested in their futures. Anybody can help her cut her own throat.
I'm sure you'll be able to manage without me just this once.
I think we can handle it.
I don't see why not. It's just a routine matter.
What did she do?
Miss Davidson was caught smuggling drugs.
Yes. Mrs. Jackson, this business about Mrs. Davidson's dodgy,
Did Miss Bennett...
She happened to mention it, yes, yeah, just in passing. I wondered if you'd, noticed anything.
Noticed?
I don't quite know how to put this without sounding like one of the boys in blue. Far be it from me to question Mrs. Davidson's probity, so to speak. We all know what a personal involvement... there are a few worrying elements here.
I don't think so.
Mrs. Davidson believes in a fair go for the girls.
Oh, yes, as I said. No need to coddle the girls, eh?
Certainly not.
Now, take that first girl there. What was her name? Davidson. My first impulse was to be a lot harsher with her. I know that type.
I know what you mean.
Damn!
Stop here, Monroe!
Get up, Davidson. Didn't you hear the bells? Davidson, are you deaf? Get up at once. I don't find it at all amusing. You'll be in solitary if you don't move.
Go and wash your face.
Better leave her alone, you'll be bored.
What are you talking about?
Special dispensation. Yeah, she's the governor. You upset her and you'll be in it right up to the neck.